Dear children, today we will learn about one story from your book, Marigold. Children, you must have heard the stories of Akbar and Birbal. Birbal was very clever and intelligent. He could solve any trouble given to him. So, he was admired by the king and others also. Today, we will know about another story of Birbal, that is, the scholar's mother tongue. Let's enjoy this story, the scholar's mother tongue. A learned Pandit once visited the court of Akbar. He told the king and his courtiers that he had mastery over many different languages. The Pandit could speak many languages fluently. He was so fluent that no one could find out what his mother tongue was. He challenged everybody at the court to name his mother tongue. When everyone failed, the challenge was taken up by Birbal. That night, Birbal went quietly to the Pandit's room when he was asleep. He whispered into the Pandit's ear and tickled it with a feather. The Pandit, half awake, cried out suddenly and shouted out words in his mother tongue. Birbal came to the court the next day and told everyone that the Pandit's mother tongue was Telugu. The Pandit was surprised and accepted the truth. King Akbar then asked Birbal, "How did you find the truth?" Birbal answered, "In times of difficulty, a person speaks only in his mother tongue." He also told the king how he had gone to the Pandit's room at night to find out the truth. Children, look at the picture. This is the picture of King Akbar and the court of Akbar. All the courtiers are standing in front of him. Let us see some new words from this story. First is courtiers, means people at the king's court. The next word is tickle. You can see in the picture, Birbal is tickling into the ears of the Pandit using one feather. Do you tickle each other? It's very funny. It's very funful when someone tickles us. The next word is learned. It means highly educated. Children, can you see the photos? Do you know them? First one is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He is also known as the Missile Man of India. He was also the President of India. And the second photo is of Swami Vivekananda Ji. He is best known for his famous 1893 speech where he introduced Hinduism to the Western world in Chicago. His birthday is celebrated as National Youth Day. He is the greatest source of achievement, pride and inspiration. He taught us unconditional love, reinforced the importance of giving back and taught us how to be a better person. The next word is whisper. It means to speak in a low and soft voice. We can play this whispering game when the school reopens. Children, let us know some more word meaning. First, answered, it means replied. Mastery means thorough knowledge. Fluently, to speak smoothly. Challenged, called to solve the problem. Difficulty, you know it, it's trouble. Now let us know some portion of the grammar. See how to use a and an. Uses and examples. First, a used before words beginning with a consonant sound. For example, a man, a lamp, a cat. Second one, an. Used before words that begin with a vowel sound. For example, an apple, an eraser, an umbrella. I know you can also give many examples. Children, do you know what is it? Which country is it? Yes, it's our own country, our beloved India. How many states are there in India? Yes, there are so many states. Every state has its own language and different culture. Still, we are one. So we say, unity in diversity. Children, have you visited any other states of India? Do you know their languages? Let's try. You have to match the states with their languages. The states are Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha. The languages given are Konkani, Odia, Tamil, Kannad and Marathi. I hope you can do this. Let's do some homework. Some questions are there. Very easy question. You are very intelligent. You all can do it. First question is, who came to Akbar's court? You know very well. Second, what did he claim to know? Third, how did he challenge everybody? Four, add a or an at correct place. Rug, pillow, bed sheet, waistcoat, long coat, apple, orange, banana, and ice cream. You have to put a or an. Thank you and have a wonderful day.